Hey friends, so let's solve 2018 AP ESET question paper, chemistry paper. So what's the first question? Pauli's exclusion principle states that two electrons in the same orbital. So no two electrons in the same orbital can have the same spin. So simply same states that it can have same spin. So the answer here is opposite spins. So I'll explain why. So what exactly is Pauli's exclusion principle state? So it states that no two electrons in the same electron atom can have identical values or all the four of their quantum numbers. So see, observe this. Here these two are in the same direction, whereas here they are in the opposite direction. So I have to remember. So Pauli's exclusion principle clearly states that the two electrons in the same orbital must have opposite spins. So next, let's go to the next question. So orbits in which electrons move according to the Bohr are. So the electrons move in circular orbits. We'll see why exactly it is. So in Bohr model of atom, electrons travel in a defined circular orbits around the nucleus. So the orbits are labeled by integer quantum number, and these electrons can jump from one orbit to another orbit by absorbing energy. So we have the nucleus here, then we have K, L, M and N shells. Okay, so next, go to the next question. So phosphorus has an atomic number of 15. He's asking us the electronic configuration. So here Z is 15. And if we see the, what do you call, electronic configuration diagram, I can simply get it. So here Z is 15. Therefore, so 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. 3s2, 3p. So I'm left with 2, 2, 4, 6, 10, 12. I'll be left with 3. So 3s. And I'm stopping here. Okay. So the answer here is option number 2. Let's go to the next question. So sodium chloride is classified is having what kind of bonds in solid phase? Very simple question. NaCl is a classical example of ionic bond, Na plus plus Cl minus. So the answer is 2. So see this, sodium and chlorine, you get sodium chloride, in which sodium ion is cation and chlorine is anion. So let's go to the next question. The bond formed due to sharing of electrons. So whenever you have this concept of sharing, it is simply covalent bond. So see this. So a covalent bond is a chemical bond that involves sharing of electron pairs between the atoms. So here these electron pairs are known as shared pairs or bonding pairs, and the stable balance of attractive and repulsive forces between atoms, and it is known as covalent bonding. So here you have the concept of sharing of available valence electrons. Next, what exactly is the normality of a solution? So we have the same formula, normality is equal to weight divided by, this is a standard formula on which many number of questions are formed. So gram equivalent of the solute by volume of the solute in liter, or simply by weight by equivalent weight into 1000 by the number of liters in milliliters. So here equivalent weight is molar mass by n. So W by 1000 by V. So for Na2CO3, if I am supposed to calculate the gram molecular weight, so 2 times Na molecular weight is 23 plus 12 for carbon, and oxygen again it is 3 into 16. So if I sum it up, I will get 106. So here it will be, so the GW will be GMW by charge, or 10 power 6, or this 106 divided by 2, which is 53. So here N will be 5.3, because the weight is given as 5.3, and we got GW as 53. Into 1000 divided by, again it is given as 1 liter, so 1000, so it is again 1 divided by 10, or simply it is 0.1 normal. So the next question, so which of the following solution has same molarity and normality? So we have to calculate the GMW and GEW. So normality is equal to molarity when moles solute is equal to the number of molar equivalents. So in this case, sir, for, let's see, for Na2CO3, so if you calculate the GMW, it will be 2 into, for sodium atomic weight is 23, plus carbon, plus 3 times oxygen is 16. The sum is 106, and GEW is simply 106 by 2, which is 53. So let's see for NaCl, which is GMW will be 2 times 23 plus 33.5, which is 79.5, and GEW is 79.5 divided by value. So M is W by gram molecular weight into 1000 divided by volume in milliliters. So only for sodium chloride you will be having, since both M and N are equal, therefore molarity and normality will be equal for sodium chloride. So let's go to the next question. So here 5 moles of a solute is dissolved in 10 liters of a solution. What is the molarity? So molarity is nothing but N into 1 by V in liters. So here N is 5 and number of liters are 10. So I will be getting a molarity, which is 1 by 2 or 0.5. So this is the formula of molality. So it is nothing but W by molar mass into 1000 into double weight in gram solvent. Next, 84. What is the process in which acids of hydrogen and bases of OH- react from salts and water? It is simply neutralization. So when an acid is mixed with base, we get water and salt. So H plus and OH minus, they combine, we get H2O. So simply, neutralization is a reaction that can be defined as a chemical reaction in which an acid and a base quantitatively react together to form salt and water as products. So acid plus base, you will be having water and salt. So hydrogen chloride and sodium hydroxide, you will be getting water and sodium chloride. So these are some good examples. So the next question, just in the earlier paper also we got a similar question. So a substance that donates pair of electrons to form coordinate covalent bond is Lewis base, if it is an acceptor, it is a Lewis acid. So that was in the last question paper. So both these topics are very important because every exam there is a chance of this. So what is an Lewis acid? It is a species that accepts electron pair or an electrophile, and it will have vacant orbitals. Whereas Lewis base is a species that donates electron pair, nucleophile, and it will have lone pair of electrons. So simply remember, there is a coordinate covalent bond in this case. So acid will be accepting electron pair and base will be electron donor. So very standard question. So what is the value of 1 Faraday? The value of 1 Faraday is 96,500 coulombs. So Faraday, its constant is 96485, symbol is EF. So it corresponds to the amount of electricity that is carried by 1 mole of electrons. Next, so again a similar electrochemistry problem. So here you are supposed to calculate the EM of the cell. So I'm giving this as a homework. So next, galvanic cells are the cells which convert, this is a direct question, so they convert chemical energy to electrical energy. So this is a galvanic cell. So a galvanic cell is an electrochemical cell which converts free energy of chemical into electrical energy. So remember, the photogalvanic cell is one which generates species of photochemical, which results in electrical current through an external circuit. Next, so mass of a substance produced at an electrode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity, but this earlier paper also I have discussed, it is nothing but Faraday's first law of. So these two laws are very important, every year you are getting question on this. So what is Faraday's first law? So in this, the amount of chemical reaction during electrolysis occurs at any electrode under the influence of electrical energy is proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through it, whereas in the second case it will be proportional to the chemical equivalent weights. So remember, which is for electrical energy and which is for chemical equivalent weights. Next, hardness of water, it is generally expressed in parts per million calcium, in terms of calcium carbonate. So measurement of hardness, this is done in terms of CaCO3 or in terms of parts per million. Next, temporary hardness is basically due to carbonates of calcium and magnesium. So see, observe this. So temporary hardness is basically due to the carbonates and bicarbonates of calcium, whereas sulfates and chlorides will definitely cause permanent hardness. So this can be removed by boiling, however permanent cannot be removed by boiling. So it is cheaper process, it is an expensive process. So this is an example for it. So this is also a standard question which comes in every examination. So the exhausted geolite bed can be regenerated by washing with, this is a direct question, it can be washing, when you wash with sodium chloride, the regeneration happens. So this is a geolite process in which regeneration is done through concentrated sodium chloride. We have raw water as a hardware as an input and soft water as our output. So see the reagents also, geolite bed and everything. So regeneration, Concentrated 10% brine solution is used for this particular process. Next, what exactly is corrosion? Corrosion is an example of oxidation. So see this. So rusting is a process which happens. So this is an electrochemical oxidation of a metal into a reaction, in which oxidants such as oxygen or sulfates. So rusting is the formation of iron oxide, and it is an example of electrochemical corrosion, because corrosion is a diffusion control process and it occurs at exposed surfaces. So oxygen with iron along with water will produce Fe2O3.H2O. Next, what exactly is the composition of rust? As earlier said, it is Fe2O3 iron oxide with water. So this is a common output when iron gets rusted. So which of the following statement is not true? So natural rubber is a trans configuration at every double bond. So this we discussed in the earlier topic, natural rubber, I told you about isopropene. So vulcanization also we discussed about sulfur bridges. So this is a wrong answer. Next, the monomers of Buna S rubber are, this is a very standard question which happens very many number of times. Styrene and butadiene are the monomers of Buna S rubber or cold rubber. So see the diagram, butadiene and styrene, we will have our Buna S rubber. Next, the plastics which soften when heat is applied with or without the pressure but require cooling to set the shape is called thermoplastic materials. So the student has to remember the comparison of thermoplastic and thermosetting. So thermoplastic is a plastic which is softened repeatedly by heating and can be molded into different shapes again and again. So any number of times you can do it. So these are flexible so that can be bent easily. Okay, they do not get too hot or a bit flexible. Next, which one of the following statement is not true about an ideal fuel? So we have to know about the ideal fuel. So if you observe, it must not have high moisture current, it must be high, having high calorific value, low cost, moderate ignition, but it must have less water content. So see the characteristics of a good fuel. So it must have high calorific value and low moisture content. This is the wrong bit which is asked. So it has a, it must have moderate ignition temperature, low ash content, moderate velocity of combustion, and it should not produce harmful products. Must have low cost, easy storage, transportation, and it must be easily controllable. So next, environment pollution will be affecting here. See, wherever you have only, it is not an answer. It will be affecting everything. So it will affect both abiotic and biotic components. Next, layer of ozone. This is also asked in the last question. At what kilometers also I have clearly shown you. So ozone basically is in stratosphere at 10 to 50 kilometers from Earth. So it is stratosphere.